I would like to welcome you all who are listening to this. I'm a Reiki teacher living in Sweden, north of Sweden, Umeå. And I am here today with my dear sensei, Yakuten Inamoto. So I would like to welcome you, sensei, to this Reiki talk today. And you can perhaps introduce yourself.
Okay. Thank you, Sor Karina. It is my great pleasure to be here with you and Reiki people in Sweden. Okay. And my name is Inamoto Hyakuten. Inamoto is my family name. Okay. So as a Japanese tradition, family name come before first name or given name. So Inamoto Hyakuten. Hyakuten is my, you know, given name, also a Buddhist name. Okay. I am from Kyoto, Japan, the ancient capital city of Japan. Okay. Kyoto was the capital city of Japan for about a little more than 1,000 years, long, long time. Okay. Then in the north of Kyoto, the city, there's a mountain named Kuramayama. Yama means mountain. So Kurama Mountain, you know, which is the birthplace of Usui Reiki Ryoho. Okay. So I always feel, you know, fortunate, glad. Oh, I'm so glad. I'm so close to the birthplace of Usui Reiki Ryoho, you know, Mount Kurama, you know, maybe 45, within 1 hour, I can go there. Yeah. Yeah. Anytime. But anyway, okay. So then, as you may know, that was, the birth, place of Kurama, you know, yeah, he was the founder of Usui Sensei, was, you know, sitting in meditation, fasting, you know, for 21 days there, and he attained enlightenment. Okay, that's the very beginning of Usui Reiki Ryoho, and that was in 1922. So this year, 2022, means this year is very special year. It's a 100th, you know, anniversary of Usui Reiki Ryoho. Okay, and Usui Reiki Ryoho Gakkai. Gakkai means association. Okay, so then.
Yes, and today we would talk about the Gukai, the principles of Reiki. From your Reikido, and I will put a link to the last talk, because in the talk before this, we talked about what Reiki is, what Komyo Reikido is, about Usui Reiki Ryoho. So I will put a link, if anybody hasn't listened to that, they can listen to that speak also, and have a background. More background, yes.
So we can. Now I'd like to talk about Reiki principle, or sometimes called Gokai, you know, Reiki principle, Gokai, created by the founder, Usui Sensei. Very simple, you know, principle, but very difficult, yeah, to practice them in our daily life, you know. As you know, you know, there are two titles before Reiki principle. I think I have somewhere. Okay. Okay. So maybe it's not clear, but you know, Shoufuku no Hiho, Wanbyou no Reiku. This is the title. Then Kyo dake wa means today only, or just for today. Ikaruna means do not anger, or anger not. Shimpaisuna, you know, do not worry, or you know, worry not. Then, kansha shite, with the thankfulness, gyo o hakeme, work diligently. The last one is, shito ni shinsetsu ni, be kind to other, you know. Again, simple, you know, but difficult to practice them in our daily life. For example, kyō dake wa means, you know, kyō dake wa, never mind yesterday, never mind tomorrow, be in the present, here, now. That's the meaning of kyō dake wa. Okay, but we have a strong tendency to look back yesterday, last week, the past. Another strong tendency to look ahead tomorrow, okay, next week, next year, or next month. So back and forth, past, future, you know, always like this, forgetting about what? Here, now, kyō dake wa. Okay? So, it's not easy for us to practice, you know, one of them. Even kyō dake wa, today only, so difficult. Look at the other animal, cats and dogs, monkey, deers, you know? Yeah? They have no time, so they are always in the present, here, now. They practice Reiki principle, kyō dake wa, you know, all their life, not us human. You know? Yeah. Okay. So, kyō dake wa, in other words, means be in the present. Okay. Then, ikaru na, anger, shimpai suna, worry, you know, these are negative emotion, okay? Not only worry, not only, you know, anger, we have another negative emotion like a fear, you know, I don't know, anxiety, you know, yeah, we have so many negative emotion, okay? Yes. But in our daily life, you know, sometimes we have no choice but to get angry, okay? And no choice but to get worried, okay? So I think it's okay for us to get angry, get worried, it's okay. But the point is, okay, do not get attached to your anger or to your worry, okay? Okay, the attachment is, how should I say, yeah, the very bad thing, you know, from attachment, you know, suffering arise. So attachment means suffering. And because of the attachment to this, that, you know, good thing, bad thing, people suffer. People have a lot of pain, you know, people in the world, you know, many people suffer because of their attachment to this and that, okay? So, suppose I, from the, you know, from the young age, you know, I'm kind of an angry person, that's I know, I get angry all the time. But now I know, oh, I am angry. I, you know, then I become aware of my anger. Oh, I'm angry. So I have to let go of my anger. Okay. Then it's okay. Okay. I don't suffer because of my anger. Because I could let go of my anger, you know. The same with our worry, same with our fear, Okay? If we become aware of negative emotion like anger, fear, worry, then it means, we could let go. Then we don't suffer. Okay? Yes. So I always feel that, okay, even though Usui Sensei said, do not anger, do not worry, but like I said, in our daily life, sometimes, we have no choice but to get angry. Okay? Then, I said, it's okay, but, the point is, we have to let go of our negative emotion like anger, worry. Then it's okay. So I'm sure Usui Sensei say, okay, it's okay. That's the way, Then, kansha, thankful, okay, or gratitude. This is the foundation of everything. Okay. Sometimes we take something as granted. Like the air we breathe, Like I mentioned, in the last interview, without the air, we cannot survive, Maybe 3 minutes, our limit, But usually we just take it as granted, the air. That means, we don't pay attention, we don't, give thanks, we don't feel grateful to the air, Again, without the air, we cannot survive more than 3 minutes, But again, no thankfulness or gratitude to the air, because we just take it as granted. Then we can say the same thing to the Reiki, the energy of the universe, the energy of heaven and earth, which sustain all life, our life, life of animal, plant, all living things. But again, like the air, we don't pay much attention, we don't, say thank you very much, Reiki, the energy of the universe, which sustain my life. We don't think that way. We lack gratitude, thankfulness to the very essential thing, like the air, like the Reiki, the energy of the universe, which sustain your life. So then again, gratitude, thankfulness is the foundation of everything. The working hard, working diligently, it's a good thing. And be kind to others. Kindness is good. But too kind is no good. We have to be careful. To be kind is okay. But if we become too kind, it's not kindness anymore. Some people might be bothered, by our too much kindness, So it should be, we call it, chudo, middle path in Buddhism. Middle path means well balanced, not going to the extreme. Like kindness, if we go to the extreme, it's become too kind, So well balanced.
I think it's the Reiki principles is very good, because in the last talk you talked about the healing way and the spiritual way, that Reiki Ryoho is a spiritual way, a method, and the principles are something we can also, together with giving ourselves the Reiki every day, also educate ourselves, teaching ourselves to live with the principles every day.
Yes, yes. So, Usui Sensei say in his original, you know, the Reiki principle, you know, he say after, you know, saying, kyo dake wa, you know, today only, ikaru na, anga nat, shinpai su na, worry nat, kansha shite, with the thankfulness, you know, gyo ho hageme, work diligently, and shito ni shinsetsu ni be kind to the. After this, he say, asayu gassho shite, kokoro ni renji, kuchi ni tonayo. Asayu means morning and evening. Okay? Yeah. Okay? Gassho shite, kokoro ni renji, bear them in mind and chant with mouth, chant, okay? So he encouraged us to practice, I mean, chant Reiki principle twice a day, in the morning and in the evening, okay? Yes, yeah. Then, as I always in my Reiki classes, I say, as a Reiki practitioner, Reiki principle are, I mean, number one spiritual practice. Yes, we have many spiritual practices, okay? Meditation practice, yoga, you know, yeah, qigong, you know, yeah. Many spiritual training or practices, but for us, you know, Reiki practitioner, number one is practice of Reiki principle or Gokai, okay, in our daily life, okay? Then, I said, there are two titles. One is Shofuku no Hiho. Shofuku means invite happiness. Hiho means mystic art or mysterious method to invite happiness. As a keyword, simply put, okay, happiness. Another title, okay, Manbyo no Reiyaku. Okay, Reiyaku means miraculous medicine. Okay, Manbyo means all diseases. So, miraculous medicine to heal all diseases. Okay, means no disease. Disease free means, in other words, good health. Yeah. So as a keyword, good health and happiness. Okay. Yeah. Like I mentioned, this is our daily goal as a Reiki practitioner.